In this lesson, we will cover how to perform a merge using the GUI side of GitKraken clients. So I'll show you how to use the drag and drop functionality to trigger a merge through the commit graph or the left panel. And I'll also show you a similar option from the context menu. Then finally, I will show you how to resolve conflicts that you might encounter using GitKraken clients merge conflict tool and its editor. So let's head over to my sample repository. And the branch I'll be looking at today is this feature branch here at the very top. And so I can pick up this feature branch and drag and drop it onto any other branch in the graph. And so that's a nice, easy way for you to say, drag and drop feature onto dev to then trigger all the options, all the operations that are available between those two branches. You'll see that merge is one of them. Similarly, you can take feature and drag and drop it onto any branch in the local section of your left panel or any branch in the remote section of the left panel. So now in my case, the workflow I'm following is I create feature branches off of dev, and those feature branches do need to make it back into dev. So let's drag and drop feature and merge it onto dev. So I've dragged and dropped feature onto dev. GitKraken client presents me with all the options that are available. So I'll click on it to then trigger the merge. And there you go. Feature has been merged into dev. You see the merge commit has been drawn, and that merge branch feature into dev is the commit message. Now, one thing, since we are in GitKraken client, I do want to show you something. If you hover where it says undo, so let me try to undo this merge commit. Let me just see what happens. So I'll hit undo. It'll undo the checkout. And that's about it. I'm not able to undo this merge commit. You might find some cases where you can, but the point I'm trying to make is that it's not necessarily the easiest thing to undo a merge commit in GitKraken client, but you can undo, you know, discard. You can undo just a regular vanilla commit mess commit that you make in the graph. But if you want to go back, one thing that you can do is that you can just reset your branch to where it was before. So in my case, and I haven't pushed anything up to my remote yet, right? So what I can do is I can take dev. Dev is checked out. This is where dev was before, this Captain Falcon commit. I can right click on this commit and reset dev. I know that I don't want to keep anything, so I'm going to choose to reset hard, discard all changes. And there you go. It's as though the merge never happened. It's effectively the same as undoing the merge commit. Okay, that was a bonus, but hopefully you'll find that helpful. I know that once I learned how to perform reset hard with GitKraken client, things got a little easier for me. Okay, the other way that you can trigger a merge is with the context menu. So I'm gonna check out feature. And the reason why this might be handy is because maybe you have a lot of references in that, maybe you have a lot of branches, a lot of tags. It's a little bit difficult to read the graph, but you know what you need to, you know which branch, you know the name of the branch, and you can filter for it here in the left panel. Maybe you know that you want to merge this feature branch onto dev, so you can filter for it, right click on that branch, and then choose to merge feature into dev. So this is another way for you to, you know, use the UI to make merging pretty easy. There you go. I just did that merge, and we're back to where we were previously, where now my local dev has that merge commit. If I wanted to then push these changes up to dev, I would just check out that branch and then hit push in the toolbar. And then that's how you, I'm not going to do that, but that's how you can get changes that you made locally, like a merge commit, pushed up to your remote. All right, I'm going to rinse and repeat that because, so I'm going to do that reset hard so I can get dev back to where it was before, because I want to show you what happens when you have conflicts. So I have a branch here called merge-conflict. And when I drag and drop this branch, and I attempt to merge merge conflict into dev, you'll see here that GitKraken client will say, hey, wait, merge failed. There are merge conflicts, and I need your help. I need you to resolve the conflicts and tell me what you want to keep. So when I select this, so if for whatever reason you have another commit selected, you can always select this top node here where the conflict is shown, and it'll tell you that there are two file conflicts, and those files are grouped together here in the top right corner. And what you can do, now If you just want to mark them all resolved, you're more than welcome to do so. But if you want to go into and resolve these files a little bit more meticulously, click the file name to open the merge conflict tool. So this is where you can tell GitKraken client, hey, I want to keep changes from dev, which are represented by A, or maybe you want to keep changes from the merge conflict branch, which are represented by B, or maybe you want to do both. And you can go by chunk, hunk by hunk. So there's two hunks here. So maybe I want to mix and match. So I want to keep this hunk from B, but I want to keep this hunk from A. In either case, one other thing you can do is that you can edit the file, the output directly. So whatever you decide, you can then customize it even more using just by typing into the editor, especially if there's like a few syntax things you want to update. Once you're happy with your selections, you may then click save here in the top right corner, and that will mark that file as resolved. So index.html has been marked as resolved, and it is now here under the resolved file section. I can now do that same thing in reset.css. I can go through, take a look at this file. Looks like there's only one area where there's a conflict, and maybe I decide that I wish to keep A, how it was on dev. So I can double check if I want to make any additional changes here. I can go ahead and do so by editing the editor. If I'm happy with those changes, or if I wish to go even deeper by opening this merge conflict in an external merge tool, you can do so. If you haven't configured an external merge tool, I think if you click this button, it'll take you to the preferences or a prompt you to configure an external merge tool. I'll leave that for a separate lesson though. For today, I will hit save and okay, all of my files have been resolved. I can now choose to commit and merge or abort the merge altogether. I'm ready though, this looks great. I will commit and merge and then the commit will go through. Here we go, merge. I have merged the merge conflict branch into dev. Great. All right. Well, that's how you can perform a merge with GitKraken client. Definitely helps if you have write access to your remote repos if you intend to get those changes up to your remote. If that's a non-issue, if this is just something that you're working on, we'll merge away. And if you do run into conflicts, you now have a good idea for how to use the merge conflict tool and the merge conflict editor to customize those resolutions.